Hello ladies and gentlemen, my name is April. Welcome back to my channel if you are a returning viewer or a returning subscriber. And if you are new here and you like the kind of content that you see on my channel, then please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And I guess without further ado, we can go straight into this video. So today's video is basically going to be focused on the topic of law, and specifically why I think everybody should study law regardless of whether or not they want to be a lawyer. And basically, I guess it also goes to the fact that you don't have to be a lawyer just because you study law, and you don't have to feel like you're forced to become a lawyer if once you're studying law, or once you are done studying law, you realize that this is not the kind of path you want to take. And the last point I'm going to mention is actually going to be, I think, the most relatable one. So I definitely encourage you guys to watch this video till the very end. Here are the reasons why I think everybody should study law, regardless of what they want to do in their lives. So the very first reason why I think everybody should study law, regardless of whether or not they want to be a lawyer, is because studying the law actually opens you up to a vast selection of career options. If you study law, right, you can go into media, you can go into politics, you can teach, be an academic, you can go into commerce or business, literally any career field. Well, except for maybe certain specific careers where you need a very strong background in, let's say, science. So of course, if you want to be a medical doctor, a law degree is not going to make you become a medical doctor or a physicist or chemist or anything of that nature. But when it comes to careers which are in the fields of business, humanities, social sciences, most of the time with a law degree, you can just branch into one of them and you are good to go. The second reason why I think everybody should study law is because of the skills that studying law gives you. I really can't overemphasize how much studying the law teaches you and the kind of skills that it gives you. It gives you analytical skills, very, very strong analytical skills. After reading and analyzing cases and case scenarios, problem questions, and things of this nature, you just strengthen your skills, critical thinking, analytical skills, your writing and reading skills, because you can't study the law, of course, without reading and writing. And there is a very huge emphasis on that. So in the process of you attaining your LLB, you are just going to be sharpening all of these skills. And trust me, all of these skills are valuable in all professions. If, for example, you are a medical doctor and on the side you're interested in certain social reforms, or you're an activist, an environmental activist, or a human rights activist, or an LGBTQ activist, and you have a very strong sense of justice and you want to contribute to a particular cause, but of course you're not a lawyer, you don't want to be a lawyer, and you don't have any plans to be one, just because you study the law, it's going to give you an upper hand and help you to achieve whatever goals is that you want to achieve. As long as you understand better certain laws and the legal implications of certain actions, that's just going to give you an upper hand in whatever activity that you want to do. When it comes to being an activist, when it comes to being in certain movements, or even starting certain movements, or if you want to set up an NGO, or if you want to be an advocate for a particular cause, most of these things have a root in the law, and you have a strong sense of justice, you want to achieve a change in this world, studying the law is just going to help you get there easier. And my last, and as I promised, my most relatable point is the fact that studying the law gives you power in your daily life, or in just typical everyday situations. Once you study the law, you realize that the law really regulates every single aspect of our lives. As long as you live in a state which has a standard democratic government, like Ghana, for example, the law really controls even the most basic aspects of our lives. If you go to a shop, we invoke the law of contract. The concepts of offer and acceptance when it comes to purchasing items, whether online or in person, all of these things come into the picture. If you have a problem with a return policy, for example, and you don't know the law, a lot of the time you don't have the confidence to even stand up for yourself because you don't know if you are right or wrong. But if you know for a fact that you are entitled to this, you know your rights, or at least you know where to find your rights, at the end of the day, you are just going to be more confident in yourself, and you'll be able to stand up for yourself and for other people because you know exactly what the law says on a particular aspect, or you know where you can find the law, to be able to check it and to be able to say that yes, based on the case of Fisher and Bell, when a particular good is displayed in a shop window, even if it has a label on it, that is not an offer for a customer to buy a particular good, but it is just an invitation to treat. So certain things like this, if you have no background in law, you might not have even understood what I just said. And imagine you visit a shop and the shop owner has a background in law and they are using all of these kinds of words and language to get at you and to tell you that no, you are wrong, even though you are right, but you can't even talk back because you don't know. So basically the law just gives you an upper hand in whatever activity it is that you're doing. And that is exactly why this point is the most important one, because it literally relates to the life that you're living without anything else added to it. And it doesn't matter what field you're in or what you want to do later on in life. This is because of these reasons that I also encourage people who don't really intend to be lawyers but are interested in studying the law to actually do so. Because at some point in time, you realize exactly what it is that you want to do in your life, whether it is in international relations, business, humanitarian activities, entrepreneurship, or any other field. As long as you have a background in law, you are just elevated. The fact that you have a legal background just makes you more valuable to any employer out there. And if you want to start something by yourself, such as be an entrepreneur or start your own NGO, having a background in law is just going to make your life easier and it's going to make you more confident in whatever it is that you are doing. So we've come to the end of this video and I hope you guys have enjoyed it. And I also hope that you guys have been convinced and have learned a lot from everything that I've said in this video. I, of course, hope to see you guys next time. And again, if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe to my channel. And then I will definitely see you again next time. Bye!